We are going to talk about a local record store and our record store finds for today. We got four records from Vinyl Revival. And they're a really cool little record store in Elkmont, Alabama. We'll put their link down below, so if you want to check out their location, you really should. They've got a lot of good records. Classic rock, there's a little bit of new wave, a little bit of punk, some metal for sure. Great owner there, and I appreciate the fact that all of them aren't pristine or reissues. A lot of them are older and maybe a little beat up and a little funky on the cover, but that's okay. I don't mind that. We're also going to experiment with our USB turntable here. So at some point we'll do a little samples of each of the records, so see how it comes through sound wise.
The owner of the shop gave us the turntable for free.
Yeah, it was a little turntable. He couldn't get it to work, so we're trying it out and seeing if we can make it work here for you. So first record we're going to talk about is from Germany, UFO. This is the album Phenomenon. It's a pretty beat up cover, but the album's in good condition. Here's the back, you can see there they are. Famously from this band, most famous, is gonna be Michael Schenker. And he's a very famous German guitarist, also involved with, and his brother, I think, also involved with Scorpions. And this is a very underrated group. And a song on this album, there's several good songs on this album. Most notably, you've got Dr. Doctor, but Rock Bottom has one of the best riffs in heavy rock, especially from the 70s. And it has a really good guitar lead towards the end too. All right, this is on Chrysalis Records, and Rock Bottom is about to start right now. If you have not checked out UFO, they've got several good albums from this era. You've got Phenomenon, you've got Lights Out, you've got, I can't remember the names of all the songs. Phenomenon? I just said that actually. All right, everybody, we're gonna look at our next album after this. I always thought this might be the inspiration to the song Big Bottom in Spinal Tap. Last but not least, that UFO album is from 1974, if you're keeping track or want to find out when all these different albums came from. Next up, classic album by John Lennon. It's the first solo album, Plastic Ono Band. Of course, this was two albums. There was the Yoko Ono side of it, and then there was John Lennon side of it. And if you look at the back, there's John Lennon. And this should be on Apple Records, I believe. And the year is, let's find out what year this is. I'm gonna say this is probably like around 70 or 71. There it is, Apple Records. And produced by John and Yoko and Phil Spector.
Phil Spector.
Here's the insert. So I'm assuming this is the original insert. It's pretty yellowed, so it looks like it's pretty old. And it talks about all kinds of stuff in here. The inner sleeve. So I always like it when you get that extra stuff like that in there. Well, I'll have to look it up. It's 1970, 1971, 1969. It's right around that era. Lots of famous songs off of this album. I think we're gonna go for, are we on side one here?
Yeah,
side two. Let's do a Working Class Hero. That's like probably the biggest hit off of here, but there's a lot of good songs. God, Mother, Love, I believe, or All Is Love. I Found Out, another great song. I Found Out off of here.
Oh, I Found Out about another great song.
All right. And Working Class Hero is about to start right now. It's been covered by a lot of people.
As soon as you're born, they make you feel small.
You can hear that vinyl crackle.
By giving you no time instead of it all.
Love it.
Till the pain is so big you feel nothing at all.
A working class hero
is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. They hurt you at home and they hit you at school.
I love hearing the crackle in there. Crackle of the vinyl.
They hate you if you're clever and they despise a fool. Till you're so fucking crazy you can't follow their rules.
All right, we're gonna move on to the next album. All right, next up is a classic soundtrack from a movie that I love. A lot of people don't, but
Rocky
a lot of people do. And that is the great and wonderful Rocky Horror Picture Show and the official movie soundtrack, not the stage production soundtrack. This is from 1975. You got the lips. And of course, the back cover looks like this. You can see all your famous characters of Frankenfurter and Rocky and Riff Raff. Well, Riff Raff's on the front there.
You should play Great Transvestite.
Sweet Transvestite. Should we play Sweet Transvestite or should we play Science Fiction Double Feature?
How about we play both?
We're gonna play too much. We're just playing a little bit, a little bit of a touch for people.
I think Sweet Transvestite.
Sweet Transvestite is the winner. Okay, we'll get it going here. That is going to be track number 5. And it's going to start right now.
How'd you do, I? See you met, my faithful.
If you haven't seen, I have a whole series of videos on here where I talk about each movie mentioned in Science Fiction Double Feature at the beginning of this movie album.
Don't get strung out! By the way I look, don't judge a book by its cover. I'm not much of a man by the light of day, but by night I'm one hell of a lover. I'm just a sweet transvestite.
I like how I can hear that without even having to have headphones.
Yeah, so that's the great thing about vinyl. You can hear it. Just because the needle itself is making the music and it's going through electronics and getting into the speakers or the computer in this case. But yeah, pretty cool. I can hear it even without speakers. You can hear the music. All right, we're gonna move on to the next album. The last album we're gonna do is from an LA band and it's from 1982. This is actually an EP, it's a 12-inch EP. It includes songs such as Urban Struggle, The Legend of Pat Brown, and Anarchy Burger, Hold the Government. And that would be The Amazing Vandals, Peace Through Vandalism. This is on Epitaph Records.
Epitaph
Records. And it is 33 and a third. Which one do you want to hear, kid? Which one of those songs?
I don't know.
Pick one, randomly.
Pirate's Life?
Pirate's Life, he says. First song on side two. All right, that's what we're gonna check out Pirate's Life. We are recording. He's gonna drop the needle on this one for Pirate's Life. He's dropping it. Pull down the little thing. He's dropping it right now.
Perfect.
Classic punk. So quite a variety today from the record store, right? I never owned this myself. I think my brother had it, but I don't think I actually own this. So I was happy to pick this up.
It was in the Magic Kingdom. I'd expect monsters to happen.
Something really wicked.
Vandals. One of the most iconic punk logos, the gun across the V, like an upside down anarchy symbol, of course. So that's the whole idea of the Vandals. Look at that. Like an A. Well, all I have to say is, if you're anywhere near Elkmont, Alabama, you need to go check out Vinyl Revival.
Put the record in the bag.
All right, we'll be checking in again soon. Take care, everybody.
Hopefully it's not like a 2-month break.
Hopefully not a 2-month break, like he said.